Okay, so I'm going to take you through the wrist flow. This term's wrist flow. So come to mountain pose, nice tall spine, soft in the knees. Take an inhale, sweep up, this is elements. We bring the hands down as we exhale, just gently pushing down. Then inhale, draw out in front, exhale, sweep down. We can follow this movement with the gaze, so looking up, inhaling, drawing down, watching the hands coming down gently. And then inhale, deep, deep, exhale, sweep down. So fire, bring a little strength in, and then air, purifying. And earth, what do we need today? What do we want to bring into the heart space? And water, what do we want to let go of? Then we bring the hands up, so we do that three times, then we roll down. Nice in your centre line, let go of the head and neck, look towards the knees, and then we take that up to half back, so glide the hands up to the thighs, lengthen out through the spine, shoulders away from the ears, and then exhale, release down, just let go, ragdoll. We're going to take a step back, right foot into the lunge, and just enjoy that lunge just for a moment, sink into it, nice long back, nice long neck. Hop up a little on that back foot, create a little less space, sweep up the right arm, inhale, take that all the way up into Sun Warrior, reach up with the left arm, really look down to that back hand, you can support. Bring it into Warrior Two, so bend that front knee, nice little soft shoulders, and then we take it into Island, so let it go, inhale, sweep that up, exhale, draw down. Inhale, earth, exhale, water, letting go. So we do three of these, just enjoying that movement through the wrist, nice and soft, slow, swirling round, just taking the energy around and through the body. And then the last one, we bring that up, taking it back down into our Warrior Two, nice strong pose. And we sweep that right arm up and over as we take the left one down, we rotate one full revolution all the way round, down into our lunge pose, and then we drop the back knee, we come into dragon. So I'm going to leave myself up on the toes there at the back, but you can unhook and bring it to a flat foot. And we can keep that in a nice straight line, or you can reach it forward. Push away. So inhale, exhale, tuck under the tailbone, keep a little strength there, then sweep it forward, gather in, and then push away. One more. And then we bring the hands up, prayer position. Down to the floor, take that left foot back and do unhook the feet now into cat. So we find our shoulders over wrists, hips over knees, nice long line in our tabletop. And then as we exhale, push into the hands, nice strong wrists. Exhale, sink down. Sorry, inhale. And then exhale, traveling up the spine. Don't worry, even teachers get the breath wrong sometimes, especially when we're talking. So you do enjoy your breath through three cat poses. The last one, we bring that back to tabletop. We reach out through the right arm, out through the left leg, nice straight line we create on that inhale. And as we exhale, put it nice and strong. Inhale, sweep out, reach. Exhale, draw in. Nice and strong on that left hand, pushing through the hand. All 10 knuckles, make it the whole hand that pushes. Last one, bring it back in. So we do three, it's your choice whether you do it to the other side or just on this side, and then repeat on the next side flow. So bring it down, either hands resting, or taking them above the head. Walking the elbows away from the body, feel that stretch. your breaths here. And then release the arms, uncurl, so really uncurl from that middle back end. Sweep up, inhale, exhale, push through nice and strongly and long until we've got those nice straight arms. Inhale, send it back, and then exhale, push away. Time is send those hands, plant the palms down. This is getting ready for our crow pose. Maybe we're just doing a little modification today, so we're just lifting the knees. Five breaths here if you're doing this one to build up the strength. Or maybe you're walking those feet a little bit closer towards the hands, bending the elbows, lifting up onto the toes, getting those knees as high up as you can into, towards the armpits there. Maybe you're just taking a little rest, not quite the right word, a little break here, and holding for three breaths. Maybe you're coming to your crow pose, taking a nice balance here, finding that strength, keeping the elbows over the wrists as much as possible, so you're keeping directing that strength down. If you get to, if you're in the modified, come to a mini down dog and then walk up into forward fold. Soften and relax. And then we'll inhale, sweep the arms up, uncurl all the way back to mountain pose. And we'll sweep it back, step back, right foot into our warrior one. We bring it into that element. Choice. I'm doing kind of a little movement into flight, as we did in our dragon pose, moving that back leg. But if this feels a little like you're going to throw yourself off balance there, maybe you want to keep that a little still. So this can be your option, just keeping nicely in your warrior one. Plugging that front big toe. Last one, take a sweep up. Then we sweep the arms down. Step forward. So we do the same to the left side. The same thing, starting with that three elements and then working through the left side of the body. Hope you're enjoying the flow. Power to the wrists.